Hi there, I'm Chuck McCullough, and this is another episode of Learn It Short, where we dive into a programming topic in just a few minutes. Let's jump right into deconstruction. Now, deconstruction is a feature in C# primarily associated with tuples, allowing us to project or unpack the properties of an object into discrete variables. To deconstruct a tuple, for example, we assign to a list of comma-separated variables in parentheses. In this example, the method getEmployeeInfo returns a tuple containing four properties. The assignment shown here is to four individual variables. They are declared with the var keyword, so the compiler will deduce the types. You can also deconstruct records. Check out my videos on records as well as tuples by clicking on the links that you find at the top of the video. Now, classes can also be deconstructed, or objects from class. Now, there are several ways to assign objects to variables. In all cases, the variable list is inside parentheses, and the most common syntax is var, followed by the list of variable names. Omit the var keyword to assign to variables that you've already declared earlier in code. Finally, we can use a mix of existing variables and new variables by explicitly declaring them with their types inside the parentheses, as shown in this last example. ID was declared earlier in code, while the other three variables are being declared here in place. Now, another cool feature of C# is called discards. In code, you can assign to a single underscore as a way to indicate that you don't need that value and you don't want to declare a dummy variable, because then you'll get warnings from the compiler about unused variables. The discard avoids those warnings about the unused variables. In this example, the coder only needs the employee's first and last name and does not need the ID or the salary, so they use an underscore to discard them. Now, C# automatically provides deconstructors for tuples and positional records. It does not for classes, but we can declare destructors in our classes if we wish. The syntax is to simply declare a void method named deconstruct with a list of out variables that you wish to be able to unpack. You can define several varieties of this method as overloads. As you can see in this example in the employee class, we define two deconstruct methods with different out variables. Now, why do we need this feature? Well, it was originally introduced to make tuples more convenient and easier to use rather than having to use dot notation, right? In some code scenarios, it might be easier to define local variables to hold object properties rather than use dot notation. Now, we use deconstruction in our MVC controller methods as a quick way to move data in and out of our model objects with that very concise syntax. Coupled with discards, we can unpackage objects very selectively. Now, supporting deconstruction in some classes can be very useful. Probably not something we use in a zillion places, but in certain classes it can be very useful. Now, by the way, you can also add deconstructors to an existing class, such as a library class, as an extension method. So if you had some class that you needed to unpack and you were doing that in a lot of different places in your code, it might make sense to create an extension method for that class. All right, be sure to subscribe to this channel so you never miss out on new content. And check out the description below for more information on our tutorials and online courses in C#, C++, and object-oriented design. I'm Chuck McCullough. Have a great day.